Hi, I'm Sri Arumugam. I'm the Director of Cell and Microbiology with Emery Pharma. At Emery Pharma, we provide an array of microbiological services that can help test your compounds or medical devices against broad range of multidrug-resistant strains of bacteria or fungi. Today, we're going to speak about the Minimum Inhibitory Concentration test, or the MIC test.
Here at Emery Pharma, we carry out MIC testing as per CLSI guidelines. And this is a quick method and also a well-approved method by most regulatory agencies. MIC testing will be performed either in broth medium or agar medium. It is carried out in four steps. Step 1 is antimicrobial preparation. This can be done in two ways, macro-dilution and micro-dilution. The macro-dilution uses a larger volume where we use these tubes, whereas the microdilution is done in a 96 well plate format. So for today's demonstration, I will be using a 96 well plate format. As you look at the plate, it has 12 columns. Column 1 would get the test article, which is made at 2x concentration. And when you look at columns 2 to 11, these are used for two-fold serial dilutions. We also use a growth control in column 12 as our negative control, and at the same time, if you would like to compare your compound with a known antibiotic such as ciprofloxacin, we can use that as a positive control. Step 2 is inoculum preparation. Here I have a staph aureus strain that I will be using as the test organism. This is a QC strain that I will be using to prepare for the bacterial inoculum of 0.5 McFarlane turbidity standard, verifying DOD by using a colorimeter. Step 3 is incubation of the antimicrobial agent with the respective bacteria. So the bacterial inoculum is added to the antimicrobial agent along with the growth media, and it's incubated for a period of 18 to 20 hours at 37 degrees Celsius. Step 4, which is the final step, is visualizing the MIC value. As you can see, we use a mirror reader, which helps us to carefully examine each well for visible bacterial growth. As you can see, column 12 is the growth control, where you see turbidity, whereas column number 6 is actually the MIC for this compound, because this is a clear well and has no growth. And this is also further confirmed by reading the absorbance values using a spectrophotometer.